When exploring a considerable amount of literature on medieval weapons and armor, one may feel a certain dissonance. Works dedicated to projectile weapons like bows present many arguments about the incredible effectiveness of arrows against any type of armor. On the other hand, when examining medieval armor, the author often concludes that it was practically impenetrable. Both sides referred to written sources, which, according to researchers, often present information in a highly embellished state. So, who is actually correct? Let's try to understand. Firstly, it should be noted that by medieval armor, we refer to the plate armor of the 15th century with a breastplate thickness of about 2 millimeters. In this context, the relevant opposing weapon would be a simple yet sufficiently powerful English longbow. The armor's ability to resist penetration depended on several factors, with one of the main factors being the quality of the metal used to manufacture the armor. The hardness of 15th century armor ranged from 20 to 50 Rockwell units. The most robust specimens were comparable to modern medium quality tool steel. The type of arrowhead was also a significant factor. An armor-piercing arrowhead had greater penetrating ability, but caused less damage and was easily removed from the wound. The angle of arrow impact relative to the armor's surface was also important, with a direct angle being the most advantageous. It is important to remember that penetrating armor and incapacitating the target are not the same thing. Underneath the breastplate was an arming garment, which the arrow had to pass through to penetrate the body by at least a few centimeters. For example, an arrow released from an English longbow with a draw weight of 50 kilograms could penetrate a breastplate measuring 1.112 millimeters in thickness from a distance of 25 meters and embed itself 1 centimeter deep. However, a high-quality breastplate measuring about 2 millimeters in thickness would resist the longbow's penetration. In his research on the Hundred Years' War, author Nicole wrote that a knight could protect himself from archers simply by tilting his head, causing the arrows to bounce off the helmet and shoulder armor. In the battles of the 14th century, according to contemporaries, shooting at knights in plate armor was ineffective. However, not everyone could afford such armor. Additionally, English longbowmen released volleys of arrows that often struck less protected areas, such as the thighs, and injured or killed horses. Historian John Keegan even believes that the English longbow was primarily an anti-horse weapon. Anticipating the question that arises regarding the Hundred Years' War, where English longbowmen demonstrated their prowess, it should be noted that heavily armored cavalry accounted for approximately 2% of the French forces. In conclusion, it can be said that the possessor of high-quality plate armor, in most cases, had little reason to fear arrows. However, there was still a small probability of hitting vulnerable areas that remained. Good armor effectively protected its wearer from cold and missile weapons, including the early representatives of firearms, such as arquebuses. Nevertheless, it should not be forgotten that the reality of medieval battles was such that plate armor was a privilege of the elite. The majority of soldiers had much more primitive equipment that often did not provide adequate protection against arrows.